Hi, welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we are going to talk about freeform gradients and content-aware defaults, which are powered by Sensei. So maybe you've seen it when you have a shape and then you want to apply a freeform gradient. You take the gradient tool and click on the freeform gradient, and then Illustrator applies some colors initially. Now, where do those come from? I'm going to revert that, and I'm going to paste something from the clipboard, and I'm going to select this again and take the gradient tool and again do it like so. And you see the colors are different now. It uses the violet in here, which somewhat matches over there. And let's select this one as well and do the same thing. And you see, this is, well, slightly different. They are somewhat the same colors, but they are ordered differently. So where do those come from? Obviously, Illustrator picks from the surrounding colors. Let's undo that again. And I'm going to apply an initial color to that shape. And then go to there and again select the colors. And you see it has changed slightly again based on the fill that was there when you applied the gradient. So where does that come from? We're going to Illustrator Preferences General, and there is Enable Content Aware Defaults, which is the Sensei. And Content Aware means it looks into what's already there and tries to make some guesses what you might find useful. So let's uncheck that, and then let's undo what we did, like so. And when I now go to the gradient tool and to the freeform gradient, you see nothing happens. The object doesn't change, no initial guesses, and I can start from the clean shape. So you might want to prefer that, because on top of the fact that this might not be at all what you want, the guesses are also not exact. So this is pure cyan. So let's take a look at this. Let's double click that, and you see it's not even close. So it's very roughly guess. So let's undo that and let's go to the preferences again. I'm going to turn it on again. Let's take a look at it again. This option, so where else do we find it? So let's pretend I've got a rectangle here and I want to use the puppet warp on it. So let's go to the puppet warp tool, and you see it also sets its pins in here, and these are also based on the content aware defaults. So let's undo that and let's go back. And I'm going into the preferences again and disable them. And when I now go to the puppet warp tool, you see there are no pins, and I can start from the fresh object, set my own pins into it, and do what I want to do. So these are the content aware defaults and how they might make your work easier or get into your way. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.